गुड आफ्टरनून, आई एम सुजीत कुमार गड़ाई, फैकल्टी ऑफ डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग, टेक्निक पॉलिटेक्निक इंस्टीट्यूट। टुडे वी डिस्कस अबाउट द टॉपिक ऑफ फ्लूइड पावर लैब। द नेम ऑफ द टॉपिक टुडे, आवर टॉपिक इज स्टडी ऑफ हाइड्रोलिक ट्रेनर सिस्टम एंड न्यूमेटिक ट्रेनर सिस्टम। दिस इज द सिलेबस एंड दिस इज द लास्ट ऑफ योर लेबोरेटरी एक्सपेरिमेंट। सो टेक्निक पॉलिटेक्निक इंस्टीट्यूट इज ए NBA accredited, and for that reason we have some vision and some mission also in our institute. Our institute already accredited up to 2023 30th May. Our college is NBA accredited, so our learning, teaching learning process according to norms of NBA. So my dear student, today we discuss about the topic of hydraulic and pneumatic trainer system. That means how a hydraulic circuit or a pneumatic circuit, it can be run smoothly, safely. This arrangement I will discuss with you. So this is your syllabus. Already we learned the study of vane pump, gear pump, study of direction control valve, study of actuator, different types of actuator. And this is the syllabus board, study of rotary and linear actuator, study of FRL unit, that is generally used in pneumatic system. And today our topic is study of hydraulic trainer system and pneumatic trainer system. So according to the norms of NBA, we learn the best, because this learning will help you to compete the industrial need. Because in industry there are all machines are automatic, and these automatic machines are operated by hydraulically or pneumatically. So the hydraulic circuit and pneumatic circuit is very important for mechanical engineering point of view. So you have to learn very well the hydraulic circuit and pneumatic circuit. These are some picture which will help you to learn about hydraulic circuit and pneumatic circuit. And this is a picture, some hydraulic, that is some actuator. These are linear actuator, that means hydraulic cylinder. These all are linear actuator. Here some are single acting, some are double acting, and this is hydraulic pump, external gear pump and internal gear pump. These pumps are generally used to operate hydraulic circuit. And these are various types of circuits, that is bleed off circuit, sequencing circuit, hydraulic circuit for shaping machine, pump unloading circuit, meter in circuit, meter out circuit, and this circuit that is used to operate milling machine, and this is motion synchronization circuit. These are the hydraulic circuit. So when we consider a circuit, there are so many components. These components, that is, you see that the components required to operate the hydraulic circuit, that is number one, that is the pump, hydraulic pump. This is the one of the main component, and second component, that is safety device, that is relief valve. This is the relief valve, and third component, that is direction control valve. This is the direction control valve, and this is the actuator. That means this hydraulic energy is converted into mechanical energy by this component. The name of the component is actuator. So this circuit, we can make an arrangement in a board by which the different component are placed and connect them with the pump, and when we operate manually or automatically, the hydraulic energy of the pump, that is transferred to the actuator. Finally, this actuator convert this hydraulic energy into mechanical energy. So we will discuss a circuit. Hello student, today that is the hydraulic circuit, how the hydraulic circuit it can be operated safely. Let us study these circuit, then I will gather some knowledge what are the component in a circuit and how the components works, and this component, arrangement of this component, what will be the arrangement of this component. So this is meter in circuit and meter out circuit. That means meter in circuit means at the entry of the actuator, that is controlled by flow control valve, and meter out circuit at the exit of the actuator, that is in meter in circuit, the high pressure fluid, that is controlled at the entry of the actuator, that is, this is the flow control valve at the entry of the actuator, and meter out circuit, this flow is controlled at the exit of the actuator, that means at the outlet of the actuator. That means when this movement of the piston like this, and this movement is controlled by this flow control valve, and here the fluid flow is controlled, so velocity of the cylinder, that is controlled by supplying rated amount of fluid with the help of flow control valve. So the components here, that is, this is the symbol of tank, and this is the symbol of filter, and this is the symbol of motor. This is the symbol of motor, that means motor, and this is the symbol of pump, hydraulic pump, and this hydraulic pump generate hydraulic fluid, that means mechanical energy converted into hydraulic energy, and this hydraulic energy is transferred to the direction control valve. This is the direction control valve. What is the specification of the direction control valve? Now this is the 4 by 2 direction control valve. What is the 4 by 2? 4 by 2 means 4 way and 2 position. That is the 4 by 2 direction control valve, and this is the flow control valve. Finally, the high pressure fluid, it is enter into the cylinder. Cylinder means this is the linear actuator. When high pressure fluid enter this side, the piston starts move this side. If their load is applied, in this part, then this piston rod overcome this load. That means with the help of hydraulic energy we can overcome some resistance. And the controlling, for controlling the circuit, here pressure relief valve is also provided, PRV, that is the pressure relief valve, PRV, pressure reducing valve or pressure relief valve, RQ pump, that is the hydraulic pump, and P1, P2, P3 is the pressure gauge. Here pressure gauge for safety, what are the pressure here, what are the pressure here, when it is required to calculate the power loss, the all section they are required the pressure. And this is the check valve, this is check valve, one way valve, this is the flow control valve, and these valves are provided because flow control valve which controls the amount of fluid flow to the actuator. And FCV, that is the flow control valve, this is here. And all these component here also, only difference this flow control valve here fitted at the entry of the actuator and here fitted at the exit of the actuator. So this circuit, when we want to operate this circuit, so what type of arrangement is required in a board? This arrangement I will show you, that what are the arrangement required to operate the circuit safely. Next, start. This is a hydraulic trainer kit. In this board there are hydraulic trainer kit. In this board there are so many arrangements are there to operate a particular circuit. The arrangement, that is this is the direction control valve, and this is the flow control valve, and this is the that means pressure relief valve, and here this is the supply, that means the and this is the actuator. In this actuator, when we connect from the direction control valve to the actuator, and this direction control valve is connected to the pump, this is the switch of the pump, then from the pump this high pressure fluid comes to direction control valve, and this direction control valve supplied this fluid to the actuator. If we require flow control valve, then we connect flow control valve, and from the flow control valve we connect with the actuator. This is the double acting actuator, and this is the one point we connect here, and this is the another point we connect here. When it is required to move the actuator right side, then supply of this high pressure fluid from this direction control valve, suppose this port is connected to this point, and and from this point, this is connected to this point. So when we operate this manually, that means this port is connected to this point. That means when you operate this, the high pressure fluid flow to the actuator from this port to this port, and the movement of the actuator like this. And when we operate this direction control valve towards down, that means from this port high pressure fluid this is supplied to this port, and from this high pressure fluid the movement of the actuator like movement of the actuator will be from right to left. So according to requirement we can adjust this circuit, and this circuit can be manually operated, or also it can be operated by automatically when we connect this circuit by pilot valve. This is the pilot valve system, and with the help of pilot valve this circuit can be operated automatically. So this is the actuator. With this actuator can be operated by manually in this board. The arrangement is here, and it also operated by automatically. The pilot valve system is here. So with this help of this hydraulic trainer kit, we can design a particular circuit according to requirement. So today in our class, the learning point, that is what are the component in the hydraulic circuit, name of the component, what are the functions of different types of components, what are the functions of pressure relief valve, what are the functions of hydraulic pump, what are the functions of flow control valve, what are the functions of direction control valve, all are important. And at the time of viva exam, I will ask you all the questions from these. That means the functions of flow control valve, functions of direction control valve, functions of pressure relief valves, and functions of actuator. What are the functions of actuator? You already know that the functions of actuator is the energy converter. That means it convert hydraulic energy into mechanical energy. This is the requirement of industry, modern industry. There are all machines are automatic. So these automatic machines are operated by hydraulic circuit or pneumatic circuit. So this hydraulic circuit can be operated by this way, and pneumatic circuit also can be operated by this way. So we can design a hydraulic circuit and for our in our laboratory, and this knowledge it will help you in the industry where automatic machines are operated. When you are in your job at the industry, you will see that there are maximum machines are automatic, and these automatic machines are operated hydraulically or pneumatically. So how these hydraulic circuits works in the machine and how these pneumatic circuits works in this machine, you can able to explain, and this will help you to work in this type of machine. And this knowledge is very important in mechanical engineering, because modern industry there are all machines are automatic. Okay.